Hello, as you likely have heard, we're in the midst of a boundary process. So we thought today it would just be helpful to give a quick thumbnail of some of the changes that are underway as a part of this process. I'd like to start a little bit with what's happening with the elementary boundary specifically. The first one is Radiant is at capacity. So we are actually adding our 11th elementary, and that's Waterford Elementary. That's right here. One of the things that's happening as it relates to Walnut Hills and Schuler is they're beginning to age out. So there are fewer and fewer young children in these neighborhoods. As a result of that, we've expanded the footprint of Schuler. And you may recall that Schuler is boxed in to some extent by Easton to the south, Grant Reagan to the west, and Walnut Hills to the north. So we've expanded their boundary. We've also done the same thing for Walnut Hills. So we've extended Walnut Hills out here to the west. Grant Reagan, we have made this move to add to their footprint as well. They have grown a bit to the west. And then as you move into the Waukee High School portion of the district, we are also making a change here at Maple Grove, where we're going to make this addition to add to Maple Grove, because this is one of the smallest footprint elementaries in the south. And Sugar Creek, as you may know, is continuing to grow. So in addition to the changes that have been made at the elementary boundary level, there are also some exceptions that we are going to talk about, as well as to define a couple of separations that are occurring at our elementary schools. So in terms of exceptions, anytime you see these areas that have sort of hash marks or other forms, it means that there is a planned exception underway. These two exceptions are for any students who are in 5th, 6th, and 7th grade. And so what that will allow them to do is to continue on to Trail Ridge School and ultimately Waukee North Middle School. We also have a situation here where there's a separation. So all of this boundary is Waukee Elementary. That remains true. But what happens in this circumstance is this portion of Waukee Elementary will remain in the north, and then this portion will actually become a part of the south. And the reason that there's these lines through this portion is there is an option for exceptions for families in this area. So if you live in this area and you have a current 6th or 7th grader, they will be allowed to continue on at Waukee Middle School. If you have a 5th grader and the 5th grader is the youngest person in your family, they too will also be allowed to go on to Waukee Middle School next school year. So anyone else that doesn't meet those definitions that lives in this area will move to the South Feeder in the coming school years. We also have, you may recall at the elementary level, we have a little portion right here that's going to become Sugar Creek. And so the separation that's going to happen in this particular case is these students will be joining Maple Grove. That's not the separation. The separation is that the students that live over here on this side of Grand Prairie Parkway will eventually matriculate through to the Timberline side, and the students that remain on this side of Grand Prairie Parkway, they will matriculate to South Middle School, with all of those students eventually reuniting at Prairie View and ultimately Waukee High School. So thank you for your time in watching this video. Please keep in mind that as we were building these maps, there are three pillars that have been driving this work. One is maintaining our middle level configuration as a 6-8, 9 and 10-12 for as long as possible. The balancing of enrollment of our elementary schools, including the racial and other demographic makeups, and also some attempt and work to balance our Waukee High School feeder and our Waukee Northwest feeder system. So that's been the driving force of this work. And if you have additional questions, be sure to take a look at our website or feel free to reach out to me.